During the last 100 years of colonial India, railways were the most important investment in infrastructure. Let's take a look at what we know. Before the building of the railway network, transportation in India was extremely slow and often impossible altogether. There were very few roads, and the roads that were there were often inaccessible due to the rainfall. There was water transportation along the coast and through a few major river systems. Nonetheless, the markets for most goods were typically small and regional. Only a few goods with relatively high values and which were relatively easy to transport, such as print and cotton textiles, could be sent to national and international markets using the Indian transportation network. The peak of railway building in India came during the years 1850 through 1870, and indeed this was a significant endeavor, as you can see on this map. In South India, in the second half of the 19th century, there were 10 million jobs created simply from building the railroads. By the early 1900s, the fourth largest rail network in the entire world was to be found in India. All of a sudden, much of India was now interconnected. The coming of the railways really made a big difference for trade in many commodities. For instance, the expense of getting salt fell by about 87%, mostly because it was much easier to transport salt using railways than using Indian roads. Or we can compare the year 1860 to the year 1900. Between these 2 years, price dispersion in India decreased a considerable amount. That meant in different regions or in different states, the prices of agricultural crops were now much closer to each other, because if the price in one region was higher than the price in another region, it would make sense to buy the crop in the lower-priced region and ship it to the region where the crop had a higher price. So between 1860 and 1900, price dispersion for crops went down by about 60%, and of that 60%, about 20% of that, or one-third, was due to the effect of the railways. If we take the period from 1870 to 1913, it's been estimated that over those years, railroads accounted for about 20% of India's economic growth. Government in India had a big influence on the railways from the beginning, but at first the railways were mostly a private endeavor. However, the government guaranteed railway investors a 5% rate of return. This, of course, encouraged investment in the railway network because, in essence, the investors could only make money and they could not lose money. That's one reason why the Indian railway network was, in fact, built so quickly. Nonetheless, nationalization came. Partial nationalization started in about 1880 as the government of India took over a majority ownership stake in the former railway companies. Complete nationalization of the rail network took place between 1924 and 1927 as the colonial government completely took over the railways and the railway network. Interestingly, following nationalization, it seems that costs fell for the operation of the railway network. This is perhaps counterintuitive because very often private companies are more efficient than governments. But think about that initial incentive of a 5% guaranteed rate of return. It also means that a private company can invest as much as it wants and not have to worry very much about costs and still get that 5% rate of return. Obviously, what happened is that the private investors did not worry much about costs, and the nationalized railway system was in some regards more efficient. To read more on these topics, you can Google to some excellent pieces by Dan Bogert and Latika Chowdhury on the Indian railways, and there are also some books by Ian Kerr, including Engines of Change.